Hi everyone. Before I play the video, I don't know what I believe, if I believe what these people are saying or not. So here it goes.
This is an important message from the House about the growing coronavirus pandemic. With each day that passes, thousands more have been confirmed as being infected with the deadly coronavirus, which has recently been given the name COVID-19. For those inside China, this illness has turned life into a dystopian nightmare, where people have just as much fear of their government as they do for the pathogen. Back home in the West, very few people are taking the situation seriously, because from their ivory towers, this appears to be nothing more than just another media hype to drive up clicks and sell advertising space. Sadly, this dismissive attitude is a common response to the growing pandemic among many everyday citizens in the West, but this mentality overlooks the true reality of what has been unfolding in China for the past 2 months. Sure, there have been outbreaks in the past that we can all remember coming and going, but so much about this current outbreak is unprecedented. Never before has a quarantine of this scale been in place, keeping hundreds of millions of people confined to their homes, and shutting down trade and manufacturing for the economic engine of the world. Some skeptics have compared this illness to the flu, yet, military police are walking the streets with hazmat suits, and fleets of trucks are spraying disinfectant chemicals into the sky, which are measures that would only be taken if something very serious and very dangerous was out there. The governments of the world, and international organizations like the World Health Organization do not want people to panic, so they are being very careful with how they present this information to the public. But even these sources have grown increasingly gloomy as the casualty number continues to rise in China. Another important thing to recognize is that the numbers that are being reported from China are not really an accurate representation of what is happening on the ground, and this is something that the CCP admits. There has been a gap in the ability to test and count cases properly, there has been a problem with false negatives, and hospitals have been so overcrowded that they have not been able to admit anyone to determine whether they have the illness or not. Furthermore, there have been countless people who passed away before they were able to get medical care or get tested, and in most cases, these people are not listed in the official count. People who passed away before the illness was identified were simply listed as pneumonia cases, and they were not named in the official count either. This could be one of the most serious illnesses that our species has faced in generations, but the illness is not the only thing that we have to worry about. A quarantine sounds like a great idea, and if done correctly, it can be very helpful at eliminating the spread of viruses. When we stay home from work or school because we are sick, this is an example of an individual quarantine. However, shutting down entire cities with millions of people, because a few individuals there may be sick, can actually make the problem worse, and lead to many other issues. Harsh quarantine policies like the ones chosen by the Chinese government in this particular circumstance have been known to backfire. In an environment of fear, where large groups of people are subjected to punishments and constant screenings, people are more likely to hide their symptoms and less likely to take other measures to avoid germs. China has a reputation for ruling with an iron fist, but it is very possible that similar measures could be taken in other countries. In fact, the World Health Organization has praised China's response to the crisis, saying that the country has set a new standard for outbreak response, but does that standard entail military rule and cities on constant lockdown? We are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.
It's crazy. Part of it's hard not to wonder if it, how much of it's real or how much of it's BS. But things that they say make a lot of sense. Like and subscribe. Hit that bell if you want to be notified when I get a new video out. Bye. Silky signing off.